In our modern world, fashion has become more than just a means of self-expression. It's a multi-billion-dollar industry that shapes our culture and fuels our desire for the latest trends. But behind the glitz and glamour lies a dark truth that cannot be ignored. In 2012, the world witnessed one of the deadliest garment factory fires in Dhaka, Bangladesh. At least 117 people were confirmed dead in the fire, and over 200 were injured. Then again in 2013, the Rana Plaza disaster unfolded. Over 1,000 lives were lost, all to meet the demands of the insatiable global fashion market. From toxic chemical pollution to excessive waste, the fashion industry has become one of the biggest contributors to environmental degradation. The youth of today, however, refuse to accept this unsustainable reality. Let's look into some of the ways the youth of Dubai are incorporating sustainability with fashion, how they are embracing innovative solutions and reimagining the industry's landscape.
Hi, I'm Karen. I'm a 20-year-old fashion design student here in Dubai. I've always been a creative kid and I've always loved fashion. Coming from a Middle Eastern background, my parents wanted me to go into dentistry. After months of arguing, I finally stepped my foot down. It was honestly very freeing for me to finally be able to pursue something that has always been my calling. My journey has been so fun. Even if I'm bombarded with so much work, I still enjoy every second of it. So this is my final piece for emergency room that I made. It really, like, honestly, it killed me, especially the jacket, because I used the slashing technique and got bruises from it. But honestly, I think it was worth it for the way it turned out. The corset, I used a scarf that I thrifted. It sort of imitated Persian rugs. I chose to use a dress and not denim jeans because the dress had a thinner sort of denim. I wanted it to be more draped and looser. The maxi skirt, I also used thrifted denim jeans. And for these panels, I used ties that I thrifted, and I opened all the ties up at the seams and I ironed them to create flat pieces of fabric. I just used them as little accent pieces in my skirt. Apart from uni, I just sketch on my personal projects that I can work on with thrift flips, and also, of course, my business, Total Trash. I make a lot of handmade jewelry over here. Working on Total Trash is one of my favorite things to do because not only is making jewelry incredibly therapeutic for me, I think the jewelry you wear really tells a lot about a person, and I love using that as an outlet for creativity. So this is my favorite part of my room. It's my clothing rack. If not all, most of these are thrifted clothing. It inspires me every day to try to wear something interesting and unique. Yeah, this is my baby. If a number that a garment is worn is doubled on average, greenhouse emissions would be 44% lower, and I think that's my principle going into the fashion industry. My materials are mostly sourced from thrift stores here in Dubai. I would love if places where I could buy dead stock fabrics in bulk, but I haven't found that here yet, so I opt for thrift stores. Obviously, I look for materials that are in good condition, last a long time, and be able to be sold. Because at the end of the day, you want to make clothing that lasts, want to reduce throwaway culture. One of the most important things in the fashion industry right now is the big brands to try to come up with a change. But sadly, even though we're more aware about sustainability, brands are using that to their advantage for greenwashing. Fabrics is a really complex topic because there's so many different types. It's really hard to tell which ones are ethically sourced. If you're trying to get into sustainable fabrics, opt for organic fabrics such as organic cotton or other fabrics such as wool, and they just biodegrade better. I think one of the biggest things you can do, wear the clothes that you buy. You don't need to be wearing different trends every week. You can style it in different ways, whatever you have. Stop yourself from being influenced by all the trends you see on social media.
Hi, I'm Farah. I own my own sustainable clothing business in Dubai. So when I was about 16, I kind of started realizing the passion that I had towards fashion, but I also was very much passionate about art, and I tried to combine the two. I started off by painting on some of my old clothes. I started showcasing it online. I had some people ask me if I was selling it. That's what I proceeded doing, and I opened the store of thrifted clothing in the UAE, and I I found so many stores that had never been spoken about before. And then eventually I combined all the ideas I had at once and then made it into a brand.
When I first started out by Mercalli, that's kind of around the time that sustainable fashion was on a rise. In Dubai, you would know that their stores are not as easily accessible as it is in other countries, and they're also just not convenient. They don't function as regular stores. So that's kind of where By Mercalli steps in. I kind of work through edits and photography. I bring people who are kind of faces of our generation almost. I kind of just like to show my customers these clothes can be more than what you think. The product life cycles have completely decreased since just over a few decades ago. These companies end up making their clothing from very, very cheap material. They focus on micro trends, basically only last a month. And because they start rapidly trending, everybody is purchasing these items. And you know, the basic kind of rule, when there's less scarcity, there's obviously less demand. By the time these big clothing companies have already produced like millions of this product, everybody's already throwing it out. So once I went into kind of the thrifting realm, I started realizing that not only was I like shopping a lot less throughout the years, but like I was genuinely wearing my clothes constantly. I think I would definitely suggest going to purchase clothes from smaller brands. A lot of local businesses, they work very much more ethically. You could also kind of revamp your closets, have fun with it, and see like the different things you can come up with. It's a lot more sustainable and you're contributing to your community. Honestly, the system's a little bit rigged. It is what it is, and I do think if kind of the major idols, they start taking the lead to a much more sustainable future, people will follow. And people just have a habit of falling into trends. It's just kind of the way things are. I think with willingness, we can definitely achieve much more sustainable fashion.
As we reach the end of our journey through the world of sustainable fashion, we are left with a profound realization. It starts with each one of us making a conscious choice to shape a brighter and more sustainable fashion industry. Together, let's be the change we want to see.